But man, those brats in Lady Lake. Are all the kids that bad these days?
Well, if society's abandoned them, I don't know. Is there any other way for them to survive besides a life of crime?
It is a sad era we live in.
That has nothing to do with it. Those delinquents were kicking sand in the face of those of us honestly struggling through life. They're just ignorant of the real world.
Hey, don't look at me when you say that!
Rose, so those are the things you have to think about, huh?
I don't think, I just do!
You mean you're just spontaneous? That's awesome.
Yes. No matter the circumstances, it's up to each person to decide how she wants to live her life, and for what she must be held accountable. But Rose understands that instinctively.
Seriously, can we change the subject?
Maybe the experience of abandonment will get those kids to realize the importance of responsibility. Thanks to you guys pointing them in the right direction.
I hope so.
Yeah.
If it were that easy, the Age of Chaos would be over already.
Hey, you there! Take this to the inn.
Oh! You! This is all your damn fault!
Hurry up, kid!
All the grown-ups do is order us around, day in and day out! You call this saving us? Some shepherd you are! Screw you!
Looks like they've turned to honest labor now.
Yeah, but it didn't make us popular, that's for sure.
That's fine. As long as they're keeping out of trouble.
Saray. I found this.
I guess something like this is right.
Move. You are under arrest for leaking confidential info.
Looks like Alicia came to the same conclusion.
What is the meaning of this?
I'm sorry. This is just a misunderstanding. Please take your leave, Princess. This is...
Don't make excuses. I found evidence of connections to Rowlands in this very residence. Renovations for Grifflet Bridge, order forms of military arsenal, unauthorized transactions for...
That is simply a reward for his support.
Support?
Logos is an important person who connected Rowlands and Highland through unofficial diplomacy.
What does that mean?
On the surface, diplomacy between Highland and Rowlands has been cut. He must have been negotiating with them on his own for some time in secret.
So then he's not a spy, but a liaison.
Meaning even with the war going on, there's been work done.
Such is politics.
This is a major problem. If the channel gets blocked, both countries will fight until they're both obliterated.
But no one ever told me anything about it.
Of course they didn't. Not to someone like you. I hope you're prepared to pay for your indiscretion.
In any case, we must change our strategy. We will be expecting your sincere apology at a later date.
Understood.
He tried to kill himself. So many times.
And yet, in the end, none of it worked.
But wait, that's weird. You'd think at least one of them would have stuck.
He probably wasn't serious about it.
He sure as heck looked serious about it.
Yeah. It really felt like he wanted nothing more than to die. I'm guessing this isn't a coincidence either. Hard to say.
The more we learn, the more mysteries we find.
That's pretty much how the world works.
Think you'll have some new stories to tell us about ruins?
I certainly hope so.
A holy woman, huh? Terrifying.
Terrifying? Why?
A chaste young shepherd boy wouldn't understand, would he?
I guess not. Is that a monolith?
Don't forget, we need to find the Iris gem.
Yeah, I know. Weapons ready!
Crimson Blade, ready!
Be gone! No shit! Hey, I'm not so good! Lion Tower, ready for it! Go forth! Beat the water! Be gone! Right! I gotta get off one serpent! Yeah! Sweet dreams! Yeah! Serpent of water! Hellions, sure.
Cleo!
It's a Cyclops. Emphasis on the Z. Get it?
Not really. Just give us the battle tips, please.
Nice to be able to put my hair up with a bra.
Do it, Rose.
Yuri, come back!
You act on instinct way too much.
Oh? Did your instincts tell you that?
These ones are even more adept at water attacks than Scylla. You should stand back while I take them on. We'll be counting on you, Edna.
Quick
forward!
This isn't over!
Stand together!
Stop
that! Can't be
do it, Rose.
Lord of Water!
Take this!
Blue Sun!
Right, Lee?
Free Force!
Well, well, here comes trouble.
Stitch! Strong! Serpent of Water!
It's...
self-explanatorily huge!
I see.
Were you hoping to explain?
Burst! Breakdown! As your assault! Now's my chance!
My armor plates surround!
Blue flame! Ocean Blitz! As your assault!
They are strong!
Ocean Blitz! Break on through! Blue Flurry! Pierce the skies! Arrow Squall! Pierce the skies! Arrow Squall! Break down! Azure Assault!
Be sharp!
Blue Flurry! Ocean Blitz! Break on through! Blue Flurry! Break down! Break on through! Spirit Cleansing! Elixir Fatigue! Ocean Blitz! Blue Flurry! Now's my chance!
Raise my enemy!
Ocean Blitz!
Yeah. This doesn't
work good! Burst!
Water Fight!
Break down! Break on through! Burst! Break down! Azure Assault! Burst! Break down! Break on through! Blue Flurry! Break down! Break on through!
This place is a lot more dangerous than I thought. We need to find him. Quick.
What was that?
Are you that archaeologist?
You just cut through those walking stones!
It's not like that. It's called a heli...
Stay away from me, you monster!
What's the deal? We came to save you!
We're really after the iris gem.
True, but Sarai isn't just about that.
Hey... Well, at least he's okay.
Yeah, I guess.
But still!
Look, there's the Earth in Zestiria.
That researcher dropped it.
Well, well, looks like we got a souvenir out of it.
Is this really okay?
Of course it's all right!
Thank you.
And that was the moment that Heldulf, the Lord of Calamity, was born.
He was a human being once, just like us. Unbelievable as it is.
Yes, he may have been a cold military leader, but he had genuine love for his family.
How could someone like him turn into the Lord of Calamity?
Well, he did lose his family.
I don't know. It felt like, more than anything that happened to him, the transformation was born of his own resolve.
Could be.
It's probably not anything we can ever truly understand. But I can tell this much. Heldulf finally gave up. He couldn't fight back any longer.
Too bad, though. We didn't get to hear his stories about the ruins.
It's all right. Even if we'd have met with him, he probably wouldn't have listened to your ideas.
It's fine.
But what we know is based on our own thoughts.
Even if our conclusions are different.
I'll say.
Hey! Quit lollygagging, you nerds!
Rose is still mad at us.
You know it's because she cares.
I know. I'm cool.
Thank you. Find anything?
We know that Heldolf was stricken with a great deal of pain and hardship.
It seems almost like some kind of curse.
I can see that. Bound to the curse that is eternal loneliness.
During our most recent encounter with him, he taunted Saray, preying on his emotions and trying to bait him into becoming a fallen shepherd. But afterwards, he reached out to Saray and tried to convince him to join his ranks.
The Lord of Calamity, reaching out to the shepherd.
I want to know just what happened to Heldolf to make him the man we see today.
But that would infringe on the old man's taboo.
We don't even have a clue what that really means. Maybe this is selfish of us, but still. Is there no chance you can help?
Follow me.
Maven, are you sure about this?
There's no point in stories if we lose the future in which to tell them. No taboo is worth that fate.
Oh man, nice! Check it out! That huge thing has carvings all over it! Is this from the era of the gods? I've never seen anything like it before.
Oh boy, more fodder for our resident nerds.
What's that?
To most people, this monument is nothing more than a lump of rock. However, the storyteller of time can harness its true capabilities.
The storyteller of time?
The one who passes stories to future generations. Stories of humans, seraphim, hellions, shepherds, the Lord of Calamity. It is my clan to whom that fate has fallen. A storyteller is to be a dispassionate observer. He must not interfere in world events. But I am prepared to accept the consequences.
Is that an earthen Historia? There are more of them?
The others were fine, but this one had to be shielded from the eyes of men. So I kept it for myself.
Then this must be...
Yes. This is a record of the dawn of chaos. Come, experience the truth of the dawning of this age. Perceive the light. Perceive the darkness. Place your hands upon the monolith. Then, close your eyes. Foroshkus were kusaresko, werek foriek ohish kehem omem. Do not ponder the answer for now. Simply feel. Understand?
What happened?
Where is this? I've never seen this place before.
We're experiencing the dawn of chaos. So I suppose this would be... Camlann, the Origin Village!
Well, might as well go on.
Undisagreed.
Pretty big crowd here.
No kidding. General, this is absurd. How long must we keep living like this?
I am protecting you from the invasion by the forces of Highland. I'd expect you to be more grateful, Shepherd.
Huh? This guy's the previous Shepherd?
You have occupied our village for half a year now. This isn't protection, it's house arrest.
Not to mention, the Kingdom of Highland is only acting against us because Rolands moved their army here in the first place.
Looks like they can't hear us. The Earth in Zestiria shows that which has transpired.
The strategic importance of this location cannot be overlooked just because the Shepherd founded a village here. You can trust Highland would say the same.
What, so it was inevitable?
When one considers the rise of the Highland Valkyries, yes.
I've had enough. Just leave us.
Michael, are you really okay with this? Those bastards are treating Lord Maltellus's shrine as their own fortress! How much longer must they blaspheme the Seraphim?
Brother!
It's okay, Muse. He's right that Camlann happens to be a strategically crucial location, given that we're here along the northern border. An army that controls this territory can send troops to the enemy's capital at will. Their interest in our land is sad, but understandable.
Do you really trust the words of that tyrant?
They will do as they will. We must focus on what we believe in. As a lone shepherd, with no other family in the world to call his own, I vow to protect Muse and everyone else. I swear it.
So the origin village was occupied by Heldulf.
And then dragged into the chaos of war.
Still, you can understand why neither army could leave it alone.
Is something wrong, Miklia?
Huh? Oh, well. The humans were treating Maltellus with scorn and contempt. No wonder his blessing was lost. But there's probably more to the story. Let's head towards the shrine.
Right.
Could it be Rolands has noticed Michael led Lord Maltellus away from the capital?
No. Much more likely it's just a feint to draw out the forces of the Northern Territory. They just want a pretext to declare war.
This is absurd.
Thoroughly absurd. But that's humans for ya.
You said it. The more things change, the more they stay the same.
According to what the Shepherd said, the shrine is full of malevolence, and the village is beginning to lose its blessing.
Oh no, is Maltellus going to become a Hellion?
Let us put faith in the Shepherd. He said he would never allow that, even should it cost him his life.
But still, if the Shepherd would be lost anyway, wouldn't it be better for us just to evacuate while we can?
There's no way that someone like Michael could ever do such a thing.
Right. He's the Shepherd. He couldn't just abandon Maltellus and let him succumb to malevolence.
Sarai.
If this podunk town can serve as the key to successful conquest of the Northern Territory, then I can suffer the ire of one measly Shepherd. What is it?
An enemy attack! The Northerners have arrived! No, it appears to be the Highland Army!
I will not rise to their bait. Assemble the troops. We shall retreat.
We will make no counterattack?
Would you have me throw men away on some meaningless skirmish with Highland? Don't be an imbecile.
Guess this town is destined for the scrap heap after all.
Have the order to retreat given at once!
Unbelievable! Doesn't he care about the happiness of the villagers?
This trivial nonsense is what got the entire village wiped out?
Stop it!
Sarai.
Knowing we can't do anything to intervene just makes it worse.
What on earth is Heldulf doing?
Heldulf abandoned the village and fled.
Filthy Roland scum! Sneak into the mountains, will you?
There's more over here!
How could this happen?
Shepherd! Muse has gone to the shrine!
What?
to beg the Roland's army for assistance.
But Heldon's already run away!
Muse, please be safe!
Hurry to the shrine!
Right.
Wait, please! I understand that, as a fellow shepherd, you feel strong empathy toward him. That is normal. But please, do not forget what Maven told us. You too, Mikleo.
I'm sorry. It's just... we can already tell this isn't going to end well.
We've learned more than enough here to put the pieces together at this point.
But we still need to see this through, don't we? Let's go. Right.
Mikleo looks out of character, to say nothing of Saray.
Well, of course. He was bound to notice before too long.
Yeah, but when you add in the fact that none of this is heading for a happy ending...
We all picked up on it. Mikleo, Muse, and the Shepherd all look too similar not to.
Let's go. We're very close to the whole truth.
He's alive. Oh, he's alive. But, oh my God! Now tell us. All is lost. Now tell us has become a hellion. And this innocent child. All due to the insipid ambitions of one man.
Brother, wait!
Brought us this misfortune. I grant thee eternal solitude!
No!
Heldolf, live now and forever in a hell of your own making. This is my answer.
Stop!
So, they anticipated our retreat. You are the Valkyries, I take it?
Lightning? General!
Heldolf, prepare yourself! What on earth? Stay away from us, you monster!
So that's what went down.
So Kittybeard didn't become a Hellion. He was made one.
One bearing the most terrible curse there could possibly be. And the one responsible for it was the previous Shepherd.
So then, I...
Is this the same village?
If it's not over yet, then there must be more to it.
It's not over, huh? Mikleo.
You gotta be close to the end. Shouldn't we just take a quick gander before we head back?
You look pretty bummed out by this.
Well, yeah.
I'm sorry. Sorry I'm not more bummed out myself, I mean.
You don't need to apologize for that.
Whenever a friend of mine is down, if I'm not feeling the same way, I always feel like maybe something's missing from me.
It's just like he said, Rose. There's nothing you need to apologize for. In fact,
yeah.
Sorry.
Huh?
If anything, we should be the ones sorry for making you worry so much.
We just need a little more time to get our feelings sorted out. We'll be fine.
Gotcha.
My goodness. What happened?
Such thick malevolence. I feel sick.
Malevolence of this impossible magnitude can only mean one thing.
Not now, tell us.
Born far too early by the looks of it. Poor mother and child. Neither of you deserved this. Perhaps this, too, is fate.
That child's human!
Are we not all the same when we first breathe this air, save for the vessel we chance into?
But a child born so premature won't last but a few months.
Probably so.
Zenrus!
Muse! My goodness! What happened here?
I'm afraid there's no time to explain. We have to seal off the malevolence before it drifts into Elysia. Who's that child? Celine's? Could it be she... she was with child?
In order to contain Mount Tellus within this land, you would be the sacrifice to seal the path to Elysia? But Mount Tellus is using the land itself as his vessel. Even if we can trap him here, it would be no more than empty consolation.
I understand, but even so, this is something that we humans have brought upon ourselves.
And the shepherd?
I take it that the shepherd has finally fallen?
That may be so, but fate has blessed us with a thread of hope.
You don't mean to say you will raise these children to become the shepherd and his sub-lord?
For a human and a seraph child raised together, anything is possible. However, it all depends on these children. I humbly accept your two small beacons of hope.
Gramps!
Zenrus, I have not the words to thank you! Farewell, my dearest child. Leo!
Gramps!
So, Saray, you were a survivor from that village.
And our boy Mickey was refashioned into a seraph.
So I was a sacrifice.
You can cry if you want.
Why would I cry? I'm surprised, to be sure, but I'm not sad. And now we know where Mount Tellus is. Now the only thing left is our answer. Right.
So does this mean we've found it?
I know now what path I want to take. Though I'm not sure that counts as an answer.
Very well, then. Let's consult with Maven once more.
Hey, where'd he go?
Just a little while ago, he was activating the hidden powers of this monolith. He's probably still around here somewhere. You're right. Let's go look for him.